Hello boys, welcome back to another session of video tutorials. And this session is meant for class 12th biology students, and this is for 19th December 2020. And as all of us know, we are training ourselves and getting familiarized for the possible types of questions that have been asked in the board exam for your batch. As part of it, we are having assertion and reasoning questions. And today in this session, we are going to discuss about assertion and reasoning questions in chapter number 8, Human Health and Diseases. Of course, directions you know. Answer A, if both assertion and reason are true, and reason is the correct explanation of assertion. Answer B, if both assertion and reason are true, but reason is not the correct explanation of assertion. Answer C, if assertion is true, but reason is false. Answer D, if both assertion and reason are false. So keeping that in background, let's move on. Question number one, that is assertion. Streptococcus pneumoniae and Haemophilus influenzae. Now both the terms are giving you clue, are responsible for causing infectious diseases in human beings. Of course, correct. Reason: a healthy person acquires the infection by inhaling the droplets or aerosols released by another infected person. So both are correct. So the answer should be B. One, B. Why B? Both assertion and reason are true, but reason is not the correct explanation of the assertion. That's why answer B. Question 2. Assertion. In malaria, a person experiences chills and high fever recurring every 3 to 4 days. Reason. This is caused by the release of a chemical called toxic chemical hemozoin with rupture of liver cells. Answer should be C. Why? Malignant malaria caused by Plasmodium falciparum is the most serious one and can even be fatal. The parasites initially multiply within the liver cells and then attack the RBC, resulting in their rupture. The rupture of RBC is associated with release of a toxic substance, hemozoin, which is responsible for the chill and high fever recurring every 3 to 4 days. That's why the answer is C. Assertion is true, but reason is false because he says liver cells. It is RBC. Question 3. Assertion. In spite of exposure to large number of infectious agents, humans are resistive to diseases. Reason. Humans are able to defend against most of the foreign agents due to the ability to fight disease-causing organisms, that is pathogens. So assertion is correct, reason is correct, and reason is correct explanation of assertion. The answer should be A. Question number 4. Assertion. Mucous membrane immobilizes the microorganisms in the body. Correct? Reason. Microorganisms and dust particles entering the respiratory tract are trapped in the mucus. I think the answer should be A. Innate immunity is a non-specific type of defense that is accomplished by providing different types of barriers to the entry of the foreign agents into our body. Mucus coating of the epithelium lining in the respiratory, gastrointestinal and urogenital tracts traps microbes and prevents their entry into our body. Hence, answer should be A. Question number 5. Assertion. Virus-infected cells secrete proteins called interferons. Reason. Interferons protect the non-infected cells from bacterial infection. I think answer should be C. Virus-infected cells secrete proteins called interferons, correct? They protect non-infected cells from further viral infections, okay? Not the bacterial infections. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 assertion. Subsequent encounter with the same pathogen elicits a highly intensified anamnestic response. Reason: this is based on the fact that our body appears to have memory of the first encounter. I think this should be a assertion correct, reason correct, and reason is a possible explanation for the assertion. Question number 7. Assertion: all immunoglobulin molecules have a basic structure composed of 4 polypeptide chains. Reason: the polypeptide chains consists of 2 identical heavy and light chain connected by disulfide bonds. I think answer should be B, because assertion always, yes, but reason is no link with the assertion. Yes. Question number 8. Assertion: IgG, remember, antibodies, immunoglobulin G is the most abundant class of IgGs, that is immunoglobulins, in the body. Reason: IgG is mainly found in sweat, tears, saliva, mucus, colostrum, and gastrointestinal secretions. I think the answer should be C. Why C? IgG is most abundant class of Ig in the body, constituting approximately 80% of total Igs. It is found in the blood, lymph, and intestine. IgA is mainly found in sweat, tears, saliva, mucus, colostrum, that is first milk secreted by mother, and gastrointestinal secretions. That's why answer is C. Question number 9. Assertion: cornea is considered as an immunologically privileged site. Okay, cornea. Reason: a transplanted cornea is rarely rejected. I think the answer should be A. Some transplanted tissues do not stimulate an immune response. For example, a transplanted cornea is rarely rejected because lymphocytes do not circulate into anterior chamber of the eye. That is why this site is considered as immunologically privileged site. That is blessing for us. And question number 10. Artificially, of course, assertion: artificially acquired passive immunity results when antibodies or lymphocytes produced outside the host are introduced into a host. Reason: a bone marrow transplant given to a patient with a genetic immunodeficiency is an example of artificially acquired active immunity. I think the answer should be B. Both assertion and reason are true, but reason has not the correct explanation of assertion. Question number 11. Assertion: immunization is achieved by the successful delivery of vaccines. Good. Reason: vaccine is a preparation of one or more microbial agents used to induce active immunity. Of course, we know there are a lot of vaccines different companies are preparing for COVID-19 also. So it has to be A. Question number 12. Assertion: mucus associated lymphoid tissues, you know, MALT, MALT, are specialized immune barriers located on the skin. Reason: these lymphoid tissues are located within tonsils, adenoids, and Peyer's patches. I think the answer should be D. Why? MALT are aggregated of lymphoid tissues found in the mucosa of major tracts like respiratory, elementary, and urogenital tract. That is the reason why it is D. Next, question number 13. Assertion: antiretroviral drugs are very effective in treatment against AIDS. Reason: AIDS virus is a retrovirus with SSDNA, single strand DNA, as genetic material. Again, I think this should be again D because both are wrong. Treatment of AIDS with antiretroviral drugs is only partially effective. They can only prolong the life of the patient but cannot prevent certain death. AIDS virus is a retrovirus with SSRNA as a genetic material. Next, question number 14. Assertion. Benign tumors are called neoplastic cells. Reason. Malignant tumor remain in place to form a compact mass by a process known as metastasis. So again, I think it is D, 14. Tumors are of two types, benign and malignant. Benign tumors normally remain confined to their original location and do not spread to other parts of the body and cause little damage. Whereas the malignant tumors are mass of proliferating cells called neoplastic or tumor cells. These cells grow very rapidly, invading and damaging the surrounding normal tissues. As these cells actively divide and grow, they also starve the normal cells by competing for vital nutrients. Cells sloughed from such tumors reach distant sites through blood, and wherever they get lodged in the body, they start a new tumor there. So the property is called metastasis, which is the most feared property of malignant tumors. That's why 14 should be D. 15. Assertion. Pro-onco or proto-onco genes are cellular genes required for normal growth. Reason. Under normal conditions, they could lead to oncogenic transformation of the cell. So here again, answer should be C. Why C? Proto-oncogenes are cellular genes required for normal growth. If they are mutated or overexpressed, they may become oncogenes that contribute to the malignant transformation of the cell. Hence, answer should be C. Move on to question number 16. Assertion. Opioids help to enhance respiratory activity. Reason. Opioids are the drugs which binds to specific opioid receptors present in the respiratory tract. I think this should be D again because both are wrong. Opioids are the drugs which bind to specific opioid receptors present in our central nervous system and gastrointestinal tract. Opioids have narcotic, analgesic, astringent that cause contraction of body parts and of course provide sedative effect, sleeping effect. They slow down respiratory activity, cause constriction of pupil of the eye, decrease glandular secretions, impair the digestion, produce nausea, vomiting and of course sterility. And that's why the answer has to be D. Question number 17. Assertion. Morphine is very effective and sedative painkiller. Reason. It's very useful for the patients who have depression. Of course, the answer has to be D. Morphine is very effective, sedative and painkiller and is very useful in patients who have undergone surgery. Come to the last, 18. Assertion. Tobacco contains a large number of alkaloids, including nicotine. Reason. Nicotine stimulates adrenal glands, which decrease blood pressure and increase heart rate. Again, the answer has to be C for this also. Tobacco contains a large number of chemical substances, including nicotine and alkaloid. Nicotine stimulates adrenal gland to release adrenaline and noradrenaline into blood, both of which raise blood pressure. It is not decrease, it is raise blood pressure and increase heart rate. That's why answer has to be C. So this is how you need to arrive at the correct answer. So our efforts should be to train you in this fashion. So keep on getting familiarized with such questions, answer more of such questions from this chapter from different sources that are available in Google. So keep on doing it. More the exercise that you attempt,